Hey everybody, it's Wednesday. I'm Matthew Alaria, and you're watching the Faithful Life broadcast. Let's pray and release faith over today's broadcast, and then we're going to get right into the Word. Father, we do thank you again today, Lord, for your Word. We ask you again today for revelation of it. We ask you for grace and help to hear it, to receive it, to put it into practice, and to see it work in our lives, and we do thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, all this week on the broadcast, we're doing a series of teachings entitled Seek First. And in this teaching, we're learning how vitally important it is that God and His things be first place and have first priority in our lives. Now, let's go back over to Matthew chapter 6 and look at verse 33 again. Jesus said there, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you." Now, in this chapter, the disciples were worried about provision for their lives. They were worried about what they were going to eat, what they were going to wear, what they were going to drink. And in this verse, Jesus is telling them that if you seek first the kingdom, if you make God and His things first place and first priority in your life, then all these things that concern you will be taken care of. And friend, we talked about this on yesterday's broadcast, that so many people are having so many problems in their lives because God and His things are not first place. You know, if you don't seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, then those things that concern you, they will not be taken care of, and you're going to have a lot of problems in your life. And so it's vital that you and I make God and His things first place in our lives. Why? Because it is a foundation principle to seeing the things that concern us get taken care of. And if we seek first the kingdom, all these things that concern us will be taken care of. And so putting God first comes with great benefits. And one of the benefits is that if we put Him first, the things that concern us will be taken care of. Well, what if we don't put Him first? Will all those things that concern us be taken care of anyway? If we don't put Him first, if we don't seek first the kingdom, will all those things be added to us anyway? The answer is no. You know, in Psalm 37, verse 4, it says this, "Delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart." The CEV says, "Do what the Lord wants, and He will give you the desires of your heart." And so here's another great benefit of making God and His things first place in your life. The scripture said, if you do what the Lord wants, if you delight yourself in the Lord, He will give you the desires of your heart. Well, again, what if God is not first? What if you don't delight yourself in the Lord? And what if you don't do what the Lord wants you to do? Will He give you the desires of your heart anyway? The answer is no. And so that's another great benefit from putting God first place in your life. The scripture says when you do that, God will actually give you what your heart desires. And so that's another great benefit of making Him first priority and first place in your life. In John 15, 7, Jesus said this, "If you abide in Me and My words abide in you, you shall ask what you will and it will be done unto you." What's Jesus saying? If I'm first place in your life, if you abide in Me and My words abide in you, then ask whatever you want and I'll give it to you. Well, I'd call that a great benefit, wouldn't you, friend? The Lord telling you whatever you want, just ask Me and I'll give it to you. But the pretext to that was you have to abide in Me and My words have to abide in you. And if that's in place, then ask whatever you want and I'll give it to you. Well, what if you don't abide in Him? And what if His words don't abide in you? What if He's not first in your life? Then can you ask Him whatever you want and still get it? The answer is no. And so you can see there are great benefits that come from making God first place and first priority in your life. What? All the things that concern you, He'll take care of them. He'll give you the desires of your heart, and He's given you license to ask for whatever you want, and He would do it for you, but He has to be first place and first priority in your life. Now, here's the thing. Many desire those great benefits of putting God first, but aren't interested in actually putting Him first in their lives. I want to say that to you again. Many desire the benefits that come from putting God first place in their lives, but they're not interested in actually making Him first place in their lives. You know, we have to watch overemphasizing half of a verse. And in those verses that I just read to you, it's very easy to overemphasize one half of those verses. In other words, God will add to you everything that you need, or God will give you the desires of your heart, or Jesus said, ask what you will, and it'll be done unto you. Well, that is overemphasizing only half of those verses. There are other halves of those verses. Seek first the kingdom, and then those things will be added unto you. Delight yourself in the Lord, do what He wants, and then He'll give you the desires of your heart. If you abide in Him, and He abides, and His words abide in you, then ask what you will, and it will be done unto you. And so we can't be guilty of emphasizing only half of those verses. And friend, to be honest with you, that's going on a lot in the body of Christ today. In our effort to win people to the Lord, a lot of times we'll quote half a verse. Well, God will give you the desires of your heart. Or God will add everything to you that you need. Or Jesus said, ask whatever you want, He'll give it to you. And friend, that's a false reality. That's building a false reality of how God operates on half of verses. And we don't need to do that. We need to give the whole verse. And the reality is that if you make God first place in your life and you pursue Him with all of your heart and He is ahead of everything and He is first priority, then He'll give you the desires of your heart. Then all the things you need will be added to you. Then you can ask whatever you want and God will give it to you. And so we can't just focus on one half of the verse when there's another half of the verse. We got to read the whole verse. And there are great benefits that come. And there are great benefits that are available for people who will actually make God first place in their lives. But many people aren't interested in making God first place in their lives. They just want all those good benefits that come when they actually do make God first place in their lives. But they're not interested in doing that part of it. They just want the benefits. What they're doing is they're seeking that kind of life, but they don't have the foundation of God being first in place in their life. And so you can't enjoy the benefits if He's not first place in your life. Now, 1 Samuel chapter 2, and I wanted to look at a verse there as we're winding down on today's broadcast. The Lord said this, "For them that honor Me, I will honor. Them that honor Me, I will honor." Well, what about those that don't honor the Lord? Will He honor those? The answer to the question is no. God said, I'm going to honor those that honor Me. And friend, if God takes care of things that concern you in your life, that's Him honoring you. If He gives you the desires of your heart, that's Him honoring you. If He tells you, ask whatever you desire and I'll give it to you. If He does that, that is Him honoring you. And if He's going to honor you, it's not going to happen without you first honoring Him. You know, a few months back, the Lord gave me this phrase, blessing without honor. And what He said, there's no such thing as blessing without honor. There's no such thing as enjoying God's blessing on your life without you honoring Him. And I know many people have given the idea that, well, it's all by grace, and so it doesn't matter what we do. God's going to do these things in our lives anyway. Well, let me read you that verse in 1 Samuel 2:30 where it says, "For them that honor me, I will honor." And so if we want to enjoy God's blessing in our lives, there are certain things that must be in place if we're going to enjoy that. And we can't expect to enjoy His blessing if we don't honor Him. What does the word honor mean? It means if we don't value Him and His things, then we can't expect to enjoy His blessing in our lives. You know, if we value Him and His things the way we should, then we'll give Him and His things first place and first priority in our lives. And when we do, that's when we can enjoy some of those great benefits. You know, in Malachi chapter 1, they were bringing offerings to the Lord, and they got tired of doing it, and they started bringing bad offerings. And they actually said, what a weariness it is. In Malachi 1:13, the CSB says, what a nuisance it is. And so God's things became a bother to them. They weren't a priority. They weren't first. They were a bother. But in verse 9 of Malachi chapter 1 in the Living Bible, it says this, God have mercy on us, you recite, God be gracious to us, but when you bring that kind of gift, why should He show you any favor at all? And so what's going on here is God's things have no priority, have no place in their lives, and yet they are asking God to bless them. And what's going on is they aren't interested in God. They just want what He can do for them. They want His blessing apart from them honoring Him. And friend, this is going on in the body of Christ today. So many people want to see God take care of things that concern them. So many people, they want the desires of their heart. Come on, they want to be able to ask the Lord whatever they want, and they want the Lord to do it. That's the kind of life they want to live. That's the kind of blessing they want to enjoy. And yet, at the same time, they can't even make it to church on Sunday morning. They can't find time to read their Bible and pray. They can't find time to serve at the church God's called them to. And so he and his things don't have place, don't have priority in their lives. They're not important to them. And yet, on the other end, they want to enjoy God's blessing. They want to enjoy His favor. They want to enjoy the desires of their heart. And that is not how it works. There's no such thing as blessing without honor. Many do. Many aren't interested in God at all. The only thing they're interested in is what He can do for them. They want to live their own lives. They want to run their own lives. They want to pay no attention to the Lord. And then yet on the backside, they want to have the desires of their heart. And they want God to give them the desires of their heart. And that's not how it works. This is how it works. When God and His things are so important to you and so valuable to you that you make them first priority and first place in your life, and you pursue Him, and you pursue His things, and you pursue His calling on your life, and you do it because you love Him, and you do it with all your heart, inside of that kind of life, that is when you will see the things that concern you get taken care of. That is when you will enjoy God's blessing. That is when you will see God give you the desires of your heart in that kind of lifestyle. Come on, when God is first, when His things are first place, when you honor Him, that is the key to unlocking His blessing in your life. And we got to be cautious about how we minister these things to people. We can't teach blessing without honor. We can't just say, well, God loves you and He'll give you the desires of your heart, and God loves you and He'll take care of what concerns you, and God loves you and He told you to just ask Him whatever you want and He'll give it to you. Those are partial verses. We have to teach people, look, if you make God first place in your life and you make His things first priority in your life, that's when you're going to begin to enjoy the kind of blessing that God wants to give you. That's when you're going to begin to enjoy all these good benefits that God has for you, but He has to be first place in your life. And friend, the good news is you'll see it in your own life. When you start to pursue the Lord like that, you will see His blessing, you will see His favor, you will see the desires of your heart come. How do I know that? Because He told us in His Word that's exactly what He will do. This is good news, isn't it? Now, as we're closing today's broadcast, I want to remind you of these things. Number one, putting God first comes with great benefits. Number two, many desire the benefits of putting God first, but they aren't interested in actually doing it. And then number three, there's no such thing as blessing without honor. Let's pray. Father, Lord, we do desire all these good benefits that come from putting You first place in our lives. And so, Lord, we make a decision right now, the best we know how. We are going to put You first. We are going to seek Your kingdom first. And we are going to give You and Your things first priority and first place in our lives. And Lord, we thank You in advance for all the great benefits that come from it. In Jesus' name, amen. Friend, thank you so much for watching today's broadcast. Now, don't forget to come back tomorrow for Thursday's edition of our Faith for Life broadcast. And we're going to continue this series entitled Seek First. We'll see you then.